Hello, and welcome to a very special edition of the Toilet of Hell radio show. This is special in that it's not even a radio show at all. Some would say this is more of a video show. There has to be a name for that. I'm not sure what it is. Anyway, I'm Joe Thrashnkill. With me today, I've got my co-host 365 Days of Horror, and we've got a very, very special event planned. We're not doing this because we had two great guests drop out on us last minute. We had definitely planned to do this for the entire week, so we didn't have any problems setting up our video stream. This is just all natural, and we're good at it. Isn't that right, 365?
Oh, yeah, just no problem whatsoever. I'm not buried in about 15 inches of snow. Everything's working flawlessly. We're good to go.
We're going to do something special today. Longtime readers of the blog know that we're both giant Dream Theater fans, which is why I've written so many articles gently poking fun at The Astonishing, the latest record from Dream Theater. The record was so bloated it couldn't be contained in one double album. It had to expand out into a goddamn video game. It is called The Astonishing, the game. And, we're going to play it today on video. But if folks aren't quite sure what they're going to get, why don't we watch this video trailer of it? How does that sound?
Exciting yet terrifying.
Right on. I like the sound of that. Here it is, everyone. The trailer for The Astonishing, the game.
In the year 2285, the Nomax appear over the Emperor's palace on New Mainland, scanning the city in a display of control and supremacy. Excessive abuse of presidential power and extreme government-wide corruption has led to the return of a feudal society throughout the country. Based on Dream Theater's epic rock opera, The Astonishing, featuring unique gameplay by Turbo Tape Games, a story about hardship, love, betrayal, hope, sacrifice. In a dystopian future, a princess meets a man with a golden voice. The Astonishing. Choose allegiance. Play as the rebel or the oppressor, the artist or the totalitarian, and stand your ground, using your influence to sway the will of the people throughout the great Northern Empire of the Americas. A tactical turn-based board game that favors the shrewd and cunning, with playing pieces representing free arts pitched against those of a dictatorial state. Use talents and abilities to set the people free or to suppress them by undermining opposing factions' control throughout the empire while building your own. Engage in the single-player campaign, easing you into The Astonishing. Set up your own matches and challenge your friends. Unlock the secrets of The Astonishing, seen from the sides of the Ravenskill Rebel Militia or the Great Northern Empire, through the eyes of Nefarious, Ares, Faith, or Gabriel The Astonishing himself. From the epic, progressive metal rock operas, The Astonishing Game. Coming soon.
Wow, that was something else entirely. This game looks terrible.
Well, you only paid $2.99 for it, so you're going to get all $2.99.
Right. That trailer was surely more expensive than building the game itself. If I recall correctly, this game is a reskin of an existing game that Turbo Tape Games put out a year or so ago. So this was fairly cheap to put together. It looks basically like Battle Chess, which is, an ancient video game, but just with somebody painting with a brush stroke instead of stabbing someone with a knife. I don't know anything about the story of The Astonishing, but the more I hear about it, it sounds more and more embarrassing. a princess falling in love with an artist with a golden voice. Surely we're not reaching here on the part of the band. Anyway, let's go ahead and just fire up this thing and see if it's actually, you know, playable. And here we have it. This is $2.99 later. We have the Astonishing Game. As you will notice, there is the sweet twinkly noises of Dream Theater in the background. I guess that's Dream Theater. I have no idea what this band actually sounds like. We've got the options of single player, multiplayer, options, competitions, and quick game.
Let's try quick game.
Yeah, I'm immediately drawn. Much like Lee Carvello's putting challenge, I am sure I do not want to play. I guess we want a single player game. We've got story, custom, tutorial. I'm not some kind of pussy that wants to ask for directions on how to play a game. So I think we want to go with story. But first, we're going to turn off this god-awful music. Thank God, that is so much better. Ooh, I like the sound effects. Oh, dong. We're going to play the story mode. Okay. Choose your conflict. I believe I'm going to go man versus nature. How about you?
I would like to see you do the conflict of a Dream Theater fan talking to a girl.
Ooh, that's good. So it looks like we are looking at a bastardized map of Europe here. I think this was supposed to be Italy or something. There's Finland called Yorkland, Fort Truth, Ballhead Corners. All of these lock things tell me through my years of extensive video gaming that I can't do shit with them. So let's click on this red button, which years of... intensive training have told me press red buttons. And we have Ironworks. And I can click on a green thing or a red thing. Or this.
I guess it's your team. Like, didn't they say you could be, like, the good guys or the totalitarians or something like that?
I mean, like, how are we supposed to know which is which? I'm assuming, just due to the laziness of writing, that the red is bad and the blue is good.
It's usually how it's done.
Yeah, we're gonna be evil. It's Emperor Nefarious himself. Okay, so we went accomplish challenges and win grand prizes during the Dream Theater Images and Words anniversary tour.
I think the grand prize would be to not have to go to that tour.
Yeah, that would be ideal.
Because in reality, we've already won that, so what's the point?
So it says that on February 6th, you can win a concert ticket and after-party pass, Ludwigsburg, February 10th, 27th. I believe that's some town in this shitty area of Ballhead. I don't care about any of this, so let's play.
It's really specific for a game that not a lot of people are going to ever play.
Hey, that sounds like America.
Guinea.
The Great Northern Empire of the Americas. I can't tell if my computer is running slow or the animation on this just sucks.
Struggling to exist amidst the climate of extreme economic and social oppression, working class families' investment in the arts has all but been abandoned. Oh no.
Oh no, people have to worry about feeding their children instead of buying Dream Theater records.
Arhis is the commander of the Ravenskill rebel militia. It is his strong belief in his brother Gabriel and his love for his son Xander that fuels the fires of revolution in his eyes. Okay.
Cool. You know, income inequality is a big thing, too. He's basically the Bernie Sanders of this fucked up Great Northern Europe America Dream Theater land. Oh, hey, holy shit. Nefarious.
In his eyebrows of doom.
He argued looks a little slow.
T-Zones of Fury.
Alright, I'll be honest. I have no idea what the hell I'm doing right now.
Maybe you should have done the tutorial.
Fuck you, man. I assume this is just like chess. So I'm going to click... Nope, that does nothing. I'm clicking.
Hammer.
Bringing the hammer down, motherfucker. Hammer.
Judge, oh, you get to listen to some old school hardcore with Judge.
And I'm gonna click on this Dream Theater signal because that must be a good thing. Oh, I did nothing. Wait, Judge? What is... Okay. He's got 16 loyalty, which is very good. That means something.
So it is the Judge hardcore band, because it's all about positivity and loyalty.
Hmm. And Judge
maybe like Sam I Am is in this, or Throwdown.
Okay. What is going on here? Oh, God.
I yeah. think you're winning?
There we go. Fuck
you yeah. did it.
I did
Game
it.
Game over.
It's my turn still, I guess.
Is there a button on this to make Dream Theater not suck?
I'm gonna just end my turn here.
End turn, yeah. End life.
Oh no, they have Mike Portnoy. yeah, I'm gonna click the Dark Nomac. Gleep meep deep meep.
Is that racist? That's I feel like that's racist.
Definitely racist.
Bleep meep is our word.
The Dark Nomac demotivates opponents over range, but lacks the face-to-face ability to convert camps.
So he's a Dream Theater fan.
This is beyond meaningless to me. Yeah, Dark Nomac, you're that guy. There we go. Oh, God. Fuck yeah. Wait, that's a... Oh, the Dark Nomac is their little fucking RTD2 thing. Good to know. That's what a Nomac is.
I like how the board is just a big pillar of flames in each corner, just perpetually on fire.
I'm not, like, a great judge of anything, but I'm gonna say I think this game sucks, man.
I don't think you're going out on a limb on that. The funny thing about this game is that it's all about, like, revolution and losing the arts and fighting totalitarianism. And just recently, John Petrucci from Dream Theater, the guitarist from Dream Theater, said when asked about Donald Trump, quote, "I like him. I think we should give him a chance and see what he can do. He's obviously very different. He's not a politician, but he's a successful man, and let's see what he can do. And I think great things are in store. So hopefully everybody will give him a chance and see what happens."
Well,
there's a lot of cognitive dissonance going on with that statement in this game.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's good that Petrucci is like has faith that things could be okay and not terrible, even though they clearly will be. Or he's, you know, just like every other 50-something white dude in America, completely untrustworthy politically.
Yeah, that sounds about right. I think you better watch out for that little drummer boy on the bottom. He's flanking you.
Yeah, man, if I could figure out what the hell I was doing, this might be a little bit easier to fuck these guys up.
I mean, you're a judge. You got a hammer. I mean, just smash him, right?
Yeah, if this motherfucker over here, like, plays his stupid lute at me one more time, I'm going to wreck his shit.
See, so maybe we shouldn't let the art survive. Maybe you do have to tap it down and smash him. How dare you flute at me, Jethro Tull.
We're gonna end the turn here, because I don't know what's going on.
You're not losing, so that's good, right? Uh-oh.
Oh, man. What? What the fuck?
Oh, he just hit you with a blazing acoustic solo, and you ran away.
Wow. That is my reaction to acoustic guitar as well. I don't know what to make of all this, man. It seems like we are getting ruefully cuffed here. I don't know what I just did, but I like it.
Oh, whatever you did, you did it.
I buffed my little thinger. I buffed him good.
Careful you don't buff him too long, you might go blind.
Alright. I'm gonna put one of these motherfuckers right here, and he's gonna just wreck shit, right? That's how it works?
There has to be, like, a wreck shit button, right? Because right now you're pretty much just putting out guys and then not really doing anything else.
Oh, God. Stop playing guitar at me.
Hitting you with that grandpa guitar action.
Man, this sucks. I'm finna wreck this guy, I think.
Okay, you got in his way, good.
Fuck his shit up, Juggy.
Maybe you hit the hammer button, or something next to the 8.
Yeah!
You did something.
Dick. Let's see if I can't do that again. No, I can't do anything fun. This UI sucks. Like, can't really make anything happen here. I'm just gonna end the turn. Oh wait, I'll move this guy over.
Let me read some of the key features of this game that is on the Steam page. Unique signature board-based gameplay as developed by TurboTape Games. We know that's not true because it's not unique.
Well, it was uniquely developed by TurboTape Games when they uniquely developed it for an entirely different game.
Single player campaign. That's a key feature, by the way.
Yeah, I mean, nowadays, key. You don't know what to do. Oh. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Suck it.
Free optional in-game competition for exclusive Dream Theater prizes.
Ooh, that sounds awful.
Sure, you get vinyl and guitar picks and all other sorts of fun things. Player versus player matches on the same device. An interactive narrative unfolding the story of the Astonishing as seen from both factions. A new level to the Astonishing narrative. A non-violent game metaphor, where playing pieces in battle over game sectors, forcing opponents to give up power and influence rather than fighting to the death. That sounds like a ton of fun.
Dude, there is so much going in on this game, and I don't care about any of it. Like, they've developed all these complicated mechanics that will anybody ever care about?
I don't care about it right now when we're playing it.
Alright, this little R2-D2 motherfucker is gonna just wreck.
Bleep me pizzazz.
Come on. Aw, come on. This UI sucks, man. I can't. Nothing is intuitive. It makes no damn sense.
So it's an appropriate metaphor for Dream Theater's entire career.
Yes. Dude, I am gonna lose my fucking mind if it... Oh, why is this so shitty?
Listen to a grown man lose his mind in real time with Dream Theater's The Astonishing.
Oh my god. Wait, can I... I hate everything about this game.
Try diplomacy. Let's see if that works.
Never. Hit remorse, hit remorse!
Grandpa guitar.
Oh, this guy's such a bitch.
Oh, he hit you with classical gas.
What do we do now, man? Like, I think we've done nothing and I'm all out of ideas.
Firewell, that sounds fun. That sounds like a Monster Magnet song.
Yeah, I mean, this is our best option yet, so.
Fire cleanses all. Yeah, can you do it on top of him?
Oh,
yeah!
Suck it!
And he's fine.
Yeah.
He's mildly inconvenienced.
Quickly, mildly inconvenience him.
See, what would make this game better is to have, like, more metal-based, I guess, attacks happen. Like, hit him with a treason shit guitar riff or something like that.
I love that idea. I don't know. There is potential here. Like, if Guar wanted to put out a Battle Chess clone, I would definitely play it. But
that'd be great.
But I imagine it wouldn't be as needlessly complicated as this. Let's put out another one of these dudes. Yeah, okay. Hell yeah. Fucking ballin'. Yeah, do it. Do the thing. Alright. We're good to go.
Are we? Are we really?
Oh, did I just lead him out there to die?
Yes.
Okay, well. Ooh.
Does the judge character have a little, like, old-timey judge wig on?
Yes, he definitely does.
So, in the future, we still have that.
Which, you know, that's okay, right?
We have rolling death machines, but we have old-timey powdered wigs.
Oh, I hit him with a techno riff. And Judgy will go here, and yeah, we're gonna rule.
I think you should use, like, your judgment powers, like, really judge him on their playing skills and how stupid their clothes are. Be really passive aggressive about it, like a mean girl or someone from Destroyer 666.
Oh my god, I can't do anything.
Is there, like, do you have any other characters other than the judge and the dark nerd Mac?
I can't seem to find anyone, no. Oh my god. Fuck you, Chuggy. Surely there's a good reason why I can't do anything here. I just can't seem to figure it out. Alright, whatever. Fucking end of turn.
It seems like they're real content with just killing your guys and not advancing anywhere.
Maybe it's like a war of attrition or something, you know? I wish I could figure out what was going on here, but even still, eh.
Still not worth doing the tutorial.
Alright, what is this guy?
Treason shit.
Ooh.
Fire of jealousy. Oh, I wish I had Grandpa Guitars. Oh.
Hit him with the mire of jealousy. Okay.
Hit him with perpetual virginism.
Yeah, fuck you, nerd.
Oh, alright, something happened.
Finally.
Advance.
We'll send this feller upwards. Yeah. End the turn. So, what I'm getting here is that this game is has tons of maps, so we could literally do this across all kinds of worlds. The exact same thing that we're doing here, we get to do this over and over and over again, just a slightly different board.
So, in other words, this is purgatory.
Yes.
Hey, you killed him!
Fuck yeah, finally. I hate that guy. God, I hope he dies. And we'll send this dude forward. And, yeah. I only get one move with it? Fuck this. God, not another one! I'm so mad right now.
So you're part of, like, Lord Nefarious's team? Is that the deal?
I think so.
His squad? So it's kind of weird that you have this horrible totalitarian dictator, but he still plays by the rules in a turn-based game. Ah, you just hit him in the dick.
Sweet.
And he left in shame.
Thank God. Alright, I think we're winning now.
It's kind of like when you win at this game, it's like being, the, employee of the month. It's you win, but you still kind of lose.
Let's put one of these dark Nomaks in here.
Sure.
And then we're going to hit him with the Razzle Dazzle.
I think you might have to roll to him first and then razzle his dazzle, as it were.
Let's investigate this guitarist, because I want to learn a little bit more about him. Wait. That's not how that was supposed to work. Okay, this UI is great, because if you highlight the guitarist to learn more about him, it gives you information about the Dark Nomad. I love this game.
Worth every penny.
Can we add in another one of these guys? Yeah. Here we go. Suck a dick. Ending the turn.
Suck a dick theater.
Okay, cool. Is this game ever going to end? Like, ever?
This is the first game. Shouldn't this be the easiest one?
You'd think so. What happens if I send these guys back two steps if they're already at the back?
Let's do some science.
Absolutely nothing. Great. End the turn.
I hope there's like a time limit on this, or you hit 25 turns and it ends.
Like, this game is available on the iPhone and the iPad as well. I initially accidentally bought it on my iPhone. Yeah, so I gave this I gave Dream Theater $6, and I will never forget it. But we're playing the Steam version right here, which is for your desktop. You can play this on your iPhone, which means that you theoretically could sit on the toilet until your legs fell off trying to beat this game, which you will never do. Do you think, like, James LaBrie, like, sits down at night, he's like, finally, time to play some Astonishing the Game?
I hope so. I mean, what else do they do other than just record albums I don't listen to and play shows I don't go to? I did actually see them once live.
How was it?
How do you think it was? It was the first Gigantor, and it was like, all right, I'll go see Fear Factory. I'll go see Dillinger Escape Plan. I'll go see Nevermore was on. It's like, it was only like $20 or something like that. It was pretty cheap, and there were so few people there that, like, I had lawn seats. It was at, like, an amphitheater that the guards were just like, yeah, go ahead, sit wherever you want. It doesn't matter. And for the most part, it was an enjoyable show. And then Dream Theater came on, and they played for, like, an hour and a half, or at least it felt like an hour and a half. And it was just the song after song, and they wouldn't end, and it was boring to watch, and nothing was happening. The only interesting thing to happen was their keyboardist was on, like, a movable platform and would occasionally spin around. I'm like, that was it. And after they played Megadeth headlined, and they had pyro go off before they started, and that pyro was better than all of Dream Theater's set.
You know, I saw Styx once at a free concert, like, in the park near where I grew up. They had the keyboard player that could, like, spin around and stuff, too. I gotta say, it was probably way more entertaining than having to sit through Dream Theater. Because, I mean, you got Mr. Roboto.
Yeah, I mean, just hearing you tell me about Styx is more entertaining than watching Dream Theater.
Serious question, is there any way that I can attack this fucker across the map like he can me?
Probably not. Because that would speed up the game, and you can't have that.
Nope.
Like, if you get to the end of their board, can they, like, king you? Can you take their queen or something?
I just kind of assume that I have to beat the shit out of those statues. Alright, we're doing this. Come on.
See, your side has a couple of different numbers, and theirs are all 10.
Yeah!
Hit it, fuck it. Woo! Hammer time.
That's all I had to do?
That's it? Oh my god.
Ah. I feel like something valuable was taken from me.
Morale one. I'm going to disagree and say it should be at least minus one.
We used too many power units, unfortunately.
Units demoralized. How many guitar players did you pull their pants down and laugh at them?
There's only one guitar player that I want to pull the pants down and make fun of. His name is John Petrucci. Nefarious!
It is in Guinea where we find the ominous Lord Nefarious. Too fast.
From the comfort of his opulent palatial residence on metropolitan New Mainland, he is able to keep a watchful eye on all that transpires throughout the empire.
New Mainland. So this is like New England, essentially.
Yes. And it is opulent, obviously.
Not enough opulence in today's video games, I have to say.
You know, we really fucking trucked across that map there.
Wow.
Yeah. Now we're in Butthole Sound.
New Loserville.
New Loserville. Ravenskill.
Of course.
I'm going to click the red button again, because that's a good one. Oh, good! We're losing faith! here we go again. We can win more prizes. This one in Dusseldorf, again, a fake place in New Mainland.
We go see the Dream Theater, yeah?
I apologize to the folks watching this at home. If this is anything as bad as playing it, this is awful, just awful.
Oh, there's the guy with the golden voice.
Good lord. Like vines racing across the landscape, news reaches Lord Nefarious himself. Concerned, he wants to see whether Gabriel truly presents a threat to the Empire. It's just some dickhole busking in the park.
Everybody hurts.
Okay, at least we know what to do now. Like, we just get across the map and we fuck their shit up. Alright, give me a hammer man.
But if anything, why wouldn't you just go, if it lets you, just straight across and smash one statue? Like, as fast as possible.
We're definitely going to try that.
What would your Dream Theater villain name be? Because we already have Lord Nefarious and Faith.
Let's see, I'd want to be, like, Tyrannus McBad Guy.
Ooh, that's a good one.
How about you?
Ooh, let's see. We have a lord, so I'd have to be a count, maybe? Like, Count No Smiles?
I love it. God damn it, this fucking piece of shit UI.
Angry McHammer Smash? That'd be a good one.
Ooh, I like that one, too. I think that... Oh, no, there's two of the guitar-playing assholes.
It's a double solo. Look out.
Oh, God, I can't escape him. All right, go, little droid man.
Do the little Dream Theater symbols mean anything?
I think that maybe they're areas for a power-up or something, but... I'm never gonna read the tutorial.
No, judgy, no.
Come on, let's do this.
Yeah, just walk all the way down there.
Fuck your shit up, yo.
It's hammer time.
Ho ho! Bitch!
You have to do this two more times? Is that it?
Yeah, I think so. We're so much better at this game now, man. Oh, God. All right. Oh, crap. He's sad. All right, I don't have much life left with my characters, so... This guy gotta die.
It's the only way. This is the point in the game where I, like, make references to songs from the band, but I honestly couldn't name you one Dream Theater song.
Images and Words is a song, maybe, or maybe it's a record, I don't know.
I think it's the record, but it's entirely possible it's the song on the same record.
I don't know, and I'll never care enough to know.
Noodly Bullshit, that's one of their songs, right? It's the name of their future restaurant. Welcome to Noodly Bullshit.
I would go to Noodly Bullshit.
Yeah, I'll have a plate of the Noodly Bullshit with the bolognese, please.
Get on down there, fool.
So even if this game wasn't Dream Theater related, it would still be boring.
Literally any other band, if they made this exact game, it would be unplayable. This is just exceptionally unplayable because it's fucking Dream Theater, man.
I'd like to see a first-person shooter for Guar. That'd be a lot of fun.
Agreed. Or like Ghoul, you know, or...
Ghoul would be good. I suppose a horror survival game with, like, I don't know, Ghost, maybe? Nope, 2 out of 3, one more to go.
I bet if Municipal Waste put out a game, it would be fucking awesome.
And that would be a fun first-person shooter. Your health is beer, and, you know, your power-ups are pizza. I think that'd be good.
Theoretically, we... Oh, god damn it! This dude fucked up my shit. I was gonna get over there and finally merge.
Can you go around him?
I cannot. Wait, maybe.
Yeah, see if you can. No.
Or maybe it's just this shitty fucking UI.
Ask him nicely. Excuse me, sir.
Let's.
I'm a judge.
All enemy camps impression. Lose 2 morale. Move all enemies back 3 tiles. I don't think either of those is going to help me out right now. Instead, I'm going to put a hammer dude, and we're going to wreck this fool. And one of these guys too, because we can. Ah, crap!
Uh-oh.
He's gonna play a stupid guitar at my base. Let's see how fast we can get down there. Yeah, it's probably fine.
It seems pretty silly just to have, like, 2, like, characters on the board for each side. Don't you want to mix it up a little bit?
I don't know. I have to assume there's paid downloadable content to this game. You know? Like, you pay a little bit extra, you get to play as John Myung.
You get to play as a keyboard.
God damn it, don't kill him, I just want to end this fucking level. Get over there. Fuck this shit up.
Uh-oh. So close. Keep faith.
Kick his ass.
Do it for Lord Nefarian. Hooray.
Thank Christ. Hey, we hit all of our bonus objectives on that one.
Oh man, you're gonna get that limited edition signed LP soon.
I'm gonna go party with the band in Dusseldorf. Do we have to keep playing this?
One more round.
Okay. Nefarious.
Emperor immediately sees Gabriel as a threat to the realm. Gabriel the Astonishing will come to him willingly and surrender himself in person to his highness or suffer dire consequences.
Again, this is for playing guitar in the park like a fucking dick. Anyway, this next song is called Wonderwall. There is jealousy of Gabriel's power as well as insecurities about the future of the Empire make him feel the need to demonstrate his superiority and his style.
So he's going to whip it out, in other words. Just wiggle it around.
Demonstrate my style! Alright, we're at the palace, and we're gonna be evil again. Let's see, this party palace is in Paris, which is, real, but Trondheim is not. We are gonna wreck faith at the palace. Nefarious declares that Gabriel has 3 days to give himself up and guarantee the disbanding and surrender of the rebel militia and cease all talk of revolution. Back in Ravenskill, there is no talk of surrender. Gabriel has gone into hiding and is being protected by Ari's men. Again, for playing shirtless guitar in the park. Gabriel cannot shake the vision of Princess Faith from his memory. It is clear that somehow this moment marked the first step on the path to each other's destiny. She loved it when he played Wonderwall. Oh, God.
You're the bad guy in this, and you beat them twice. How are they still advancing?
Yeah. Good question. Nefarious. Faith. Cool. Oh, shit. We got a new dude. We got a bullhorn. It's a politician.
You got the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart.
Passively motivates adjacent friendly units plus one per round. His action ability gives a friendly unit plus five motivation. His abilities can even bring units past their starting motivation. So, I guess what we should talk about here is that by motivation, they mean, like, healing. And rather than use the trope that is used in literally every fucking video game, we're going to talk about motivation and demotivation. I guess if I got the opportunity, I would love to play as, like, who's a really good motivational speaker? Who's that guy that's, like, 9 foot tall?
Giant Gonzalez? The Big Show?
He was in Shallow Hal. I'm trying to remember.
Oh, Tony Robbins.
Tony Robbins, that's the guy. I want to play as Tony Robbins.
Yeah, Banana Hands.
Banana Hands?
That's what he calls him in Shallow Hal.
I like that name. That's good.
So the motivational thing, it's pretty much your character slaps a guy in the ass before he goes and kicks a field goal.
Yeah, it seems that way. Says, good job, champ, hit the showers.
Go get him, tiger.
Alright, we're going to move this motherfucker here. And
Lord motherfucker. Oh, excuse me, judge motherfucker.
And then we're going to have some dickhead play guitar at us.
He's probably playing True Cult Metal by All That Remains.
Alright, I know this is completely unrelated to anything that we're doing here, but I am so glad that McNulty showed me True Cult Metal, because that is one of the worst songs I've ever heard in my life. This tournament that we're doing on the site to determine the worst metal song of all time, I feel like that one has a real chance of being a contender.
See, I feel the way that people are going to vote on this is, like, heavily based on the band themselves. So, like, even if a song might be worse, they might go, All That Remains, fuck them. Hell yeah, fuck them. Rather than really dissecting it, which is perfectly fine. But I think that definitely holds some sway.
I mean, far be it for me to tell somebody what they can and cannot hate. We're all about hating music. I'm just saying that, you know, All in the Family by Korn featuring Fred Durst is legitimately the worst thing in the world. And if that doesn't win, I'm going to be mad.
It has a very good chance. I think that one does. I also think Hell Yeah's Alcohol and Ass has a very good chance, just based on the name.
There was the other one, the Texas Hippie Coalition, the band that's exactly the same as Hell Yeah, except doesn't have any famous band members. That one is truly horrific.
Yeah, well, what they lack in famous members, they make up for in gout.
That is factually true. I don't know if we're ever going to get ahead here. I don't know exactly how we're going to do this one. I think we should just have more dudes. More dudes.
Yeah. Overwhelm them with your power.
Yeah. Madonna.
And bullhorns.
Okay. Well, we've got lots of dudes on the map, so that's got to help.
They can't rip at all of you.
No, he's gonna kill all my shit.
I think the range on the guitar riff is kind of unfair.
I fully agree. They need to nerf that post-haste. Oh, come on, man. Kill him. Yeah.
The drummers are like, stop.
Let's
Can your
see.
Bullhorn guys attack, or do they just shout into the darkness?
They're supposed to heal dudes around them, but as you can see, they did a bang-up job of that. Okay. Well, that was useless.
Oh, I'm gonna leave now. You guys are mean.
This is legitimately one of the worst games I've ever played in my life. Thank you.
You just kind of nudge him away with the giant hammer.
Now's your chance! Nudge him! Nudge him!
The thing that's happened in every round so far is happening again. How thrilling.
I think my dude's dead. I think he's gonna fucking die.
Get your affairs in order.
Alright. We can do this. We can take out four of the camps, I guess. That's what they want. Am I missing some kind of greater strategy here, do you think?
Maybe. I don't think so. I think it's pretty much just wandering around from place to place smashing statues.
Alright, this sucks, straight up. We're out of turns, we got nothing to do, these guys are killing me with their crappy guitar riff. Stop it. Fuck him up. Fuck him up.
Almost there. Third of the way there. And you'll be free from this nightmare.
This nightmare will never end.
I can still see it even when I close my eyes. What are those actions on the left side, the 9 and 10?
That's a good question. Maybe find out as soon as they stop killing me.
That's nice. Excuse me.
Damn it! We just got across the map! Alright, first things first, I hate this guy, and I must wreck him. Oh, are we out of points now? Yeah, I use all of my points to go through steps. I'm getting double teamed by riffs.
Oh, is that a... Was he playing a flute, too?
I think he was either singing or flouting, and I'm not sure which one, but I hate both.
And does he have a mohawk, too?
Yes. I'm offended that didn't kill him. Let's see, we got 9 more. Let's see, what does this do? Furious Fist. Heh. Heh. Yeah, we're gonna do that.
Reduce their morale with your giant fist.
Wow, it would be great if I could use this.
And... maybe click on it and... Oh, there you go. You fisted them to death.
Yes. They'll never forget that fisting.
Suck fish, jerk.
Okay, great. He killed my other dude. Well. We have no characters on the map.
I know when I play a video game, I want politician characters.
I mean, yeah, I guess if you're playing Civilization or something.
Yeah, well, that's when you play as Gandhi and just go to war with everybody.
That's a pro move.
You'll never see it coming. So. Get wrecked, Montezuma.
I truly loathe everything about this game.
Well, you're almost becoming a pro at it.
Might get competitive, you know, join a Twitch stream.
There's money to be made and competitions to be won with the Astonishing.
Yeah, so you were telling me that you watch dudes, like, stream video games and stuff. Like, apparently they can get some money from this?
Yeah, it's like my new form of entertainment, you know, beyond watching, like, the Netflix and Hulu stuff. It's just there's, like, professional YouTubers who play video games and release, like, one or two videos a day. I mean, the most famous ones I don't really watch, like, Markiplier and PewDiePie. They have, like, millions of subscribers and followers, and their job is to play video games online. It's kind of really impressive. I like watching a couple people, if anyone's ever interested. I like Pro Jared. I like Peanut Butter Gamer. I like Space Hamster, Brutal Moose. Just kind of fun, entertaining, you know, 15, 20 minute videos, playing video games that, like, I'll never, ever play, and they're kind of entertaining. People who do it are funny, and it's something to kill 15, 20 minutes, but they've done well enough where that is their job. That's what they get paid to do, so I'm kind of jealous.
I think we're actually about to lose this round.
Let it be so. Let it happen.
Huh.
Yeah, sure, why not? Well, you want to fist them again?
I kind of want to fist them.
Fist their brains out.
Well, the thing is, I need to put a dude here to save the game. And then, I'll put a guy here to make sure he gets doubly fucked.
A hammer from each end?
If this guy dies, I'm gonna cry. Alright.
Sure.
Yeah, it's an interesting strategy. But, you know, that's the bold AI that you can expect from Creepator.
I'd like to believe it's not AI and it's really one of the members, like, furiously playing.
You think they play in shifts? Like, oh, it's your turn, dude.
They just have, like, a little warning bell where someone actually perches it and, like, signs in to play. They, like, shove each other out of the way to get to the Dream Theater home PC. Oh, it's a 2-2 game. It's sudden death right now.
Yo, I think we might be able to do this. Let's see, what more do we have? Yeah, we'll put one of these fuckers here. Stop.
Filibuster.
It's too late. I'm gonna wreck ya.
You did it.
All right. We didn't max out on that one. We didn't hit all of our achievements. Let's see what happens right now. More choppy animation. Sweet. Empress Arabelle, ever in tune with the princess intention, sees that she's planning a trip. Always the protective mother, the empress's prince Darius secretly follow his sister in order to ensure her safety. This mean...
Like, does this make sense to the people who wrote it?
Darius willingly complies, but has evil intentions of his own, which he is all too eager to carry out.
It doesn't sound right.
No, it doesn't. Also, like, who wrote this? Like, did they give it to, like, a freshman, like, literature student? Like, use the crappiest tropes that you can think of across everything and just hand-fist it to fuck. Okay, so we're going to the fourth round, except I don't want to play anymore, do you?
How about this? Here's my suggestion. We end off here, and people can let us know if they want us to continue.
But even if they do, what if I don't want to play?
Well, if the people demand it, you can't let them down. People want to know what happens to Lord Nefarious and Gabriel.
All right. Folks, if you enjoyed this, let us know in the comments, and we might do some more. Or maybe we'll play a different game. What are other metal games? There's Brutal Legend. We could try that one out. There's the Atari game that Journey put out.
There's the Aerosmith game they used to have in the arcades, the shooter.
Revolution X. Music is the weapon. That.
You could do that. That'd be a good one.
Yeah, if you guys just want to meet me at the bar and play that like with me in person, I think I'd prefer that.
That Area 51. Yeah, that sounds like a lot more fun.
Yeah, fuck the Astonishing. We're going to Chuck E. Cheese. Thank you so much for joining us today. I would tell you to like and subscribe and all that shit, but it's not the podcast. This is the video cast. So I don't know what I don't know what to make of that, man.
We can throw it up on YouTube, and you can like and comment there, too.
Yeah, there you go. Call us a dick butt or whatever people do in the comments of YouTube. Anything you'd like to add before we call this one?
No, I think this video speaks for itself.
Yeah, I'm sorry, everyone. All right, we'll see you next week.
Bye.